Hey, music lovers! Coming up this week in music news, we'll give you the inside scoop on OSU Band's upcoming concert.
And tell you where you can see the Von Trapp family singers this holiday season. So stick around for
Bombshell Music News.
With us. I'm Ellie McCracken.
And I'm Camille Field.
And we're your Bombshell hosts,
here to give you your weekly fix of music news.
The haunting sounds of the Southern folk band The Civil Wars invaded Portland this past Tuesday with a performance at the Crystal Ballroom. The Civil Wars is made up of the duo Joy Williams and John Paul White. As reported by Ryan White for the OregonLive.com, the band is currently on tour all over the West Coast, promoting their latest album, Barton Hollow. The album combines passion and harmony with a gloomy, entrancing sound. They have already sold over 170,000 records. You can head to thecivilwars.com to hear more from the band and information on upcoming shows.
Getting anxious for the holiday season? Fear not, the Von Trapp family singers are coming to town. These four dynamic young vocalists are the great-grandchildren of the legendary Captain Von Trapp. They are renowned for their infectious and heartwarming selection of holiday classics, as well as hits from Rodgers and Hammerstein's The Sound of Music. As reported by orsymphony.org, the Von Trapp family singers will be accompanied by the Oregon Symphony, along with conductor Gregory Vajda. They take to the stage Saturday, November 26th, at the Arlene Schnitzer Concert Hall in Portland, and will only be in town for one night. Tickets range from $25 to $90 and can be purchased online.
The powerhouse music company EMI Group, which has produced music for such bands as The Beatles and Coldplay, has been split into two parts and sold. The recording division was purchased by Universal Recording Group for an estimated $1.9 billion. The company's second half, the publishing division, deals with song copyrights and was sold to Sony ATV for $2.2 billion. As reported by Associated Press via OregonLive.com, Citicorp is the owner of the EMI Group and has now been left with a liability for a pension plan worth an estimated $600 million. Citicorp has been an iconic music company for many years and founded countless great artists. We hope it continues thriving under new management.
After the loss of legendary blues singer David Honey Boy Edwards earlier this year, several of Portland's best blues players performed this past Sunday, November 13th, in honor of him. As reported by Ryan White of The Oregonian, Edwards died last August at the age of 96. Many claim that he was the last musician of the first generation of Delta blues singers in Mississippi. Edwards also played with just about every major blues figure over the entire history of blues. In honor of his vibrant life and work, Portland musicians found it fitting to celebrate him. The show took place on a cozy Sunday evening at the Alberta Theater in Portland. Proceeds from the show went to the Honey Boy Edwards Memorial Fund for the Blues at the National Blues Museum.
The Oregon State Band will have an upcoming concert at the Austin Auditorium in the LaSalle Center on Tuesday, November 29th. The 50 to 70 members of the OSU Band perform classic wind band literature and orchestra music under the conductor, Dr. Robert Brudvig. The band is open to all OSU students and performs year-round. The show begins at 3 p.m. and tickets are free with a student ID.
If you listened to the Appleseed cast a decade ago, you likely shared a mutual teen angst with the group. Since then, however, the band has transitioned into more of a rock sound. As reported by Rebecca Wilson of the Portland Mercury, the Appleseed cast most recently played this past Saturday, November 12th, at the Doug Fir in Portland. Along with them on tour is Hospital Ships, a rock band that has consistently been compared to the Flaming Lips. The Appleseed cast have transformed from simple and moody to dimensional and strong. Their 2009 LP, Sagramatha, and their 2001 EP, Middle States, features jumbled vocals and beautiful guitars, but the easygoing bass and drums are what really takes the band to the next level.
Don't move a muscle. We'll be right back with more music news.
Oh, those boys are much too much. Those boys are much too much. We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We got the spirit. We're hot. We can't be stopped. We're going to beat them and bust them. Beat them.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
Let's get a little bit rowdy. R-O-W-D-Y.
Take time to be a dad today.
Oh, those boys are much too much. Those boys.
Just put your hands up, TV land.
Yo. Paradise is lost, I'm paralyzed by the imperative cause. She's sharing a coffin with the gods that I've crossed. And day by day I'm looking for another outlet. I shout, but I've yet to be heard. The fear of flying, broken wings of a bird. The feeling's unnerved, absurd with my words. A pseudo-intellectual that's just dying to serve. A fallen angel, faith filled with flaws and misfortune. Claw marks on the side of the well. The feeble attempts and the torture. Swords drawn to the necks of the demons. Another metaphor, me just trying to protect all my feelings. A criminal dealing, led us to the brink that's demonic. Born an angel, but I'm bringing back a plague that's bubonic. A prophet like the narcotic product you got up in your pocket. With more shock value than an electrical socket. The angel act that dropped it, like the sword of that to Loki. So while you're on your death, let's speak those words that you told me. Come on. You told me, you told me, you told me. You told me, you told me, you told me.
Mom! Mom!
What?
You can't find Ichabod.
What?
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
We're back with more music news that is sure to strike a chord. Portland ensemble Anne will be releasing their first full-length record entitled Dream Punks later this month. It's a mix of familiar tracks from the band's self-released EPs, as well as a ton of new recordings for good measure. As reported by Ned Landman of the Portland Mercury, the band also played at Rotour in Portland this Tuesday, November 11th. It was the last stop on their short West Coast tour, right in time for their album release. They have a dark and intense sound that embodies the psychedelic music of the late 90s that are everywhere these days. But what sets the band apart is its confidence. The vocals take backseat to their strong synthetics and guitars, which emphasize the mood more so than the content. There's also a hazy edge to what at first seems like gritty rock. They have a romanticism that suits them well. With the end of their tour and their debut record, Anne will continue to reach more ears than ever before.
Garrett Vanderkrimp, frontman of the band Coco and the Sweetmeats, states, quote, "People don't really want to like us, but they're learning to," end quote. As reported by Mark Lohr of the Portland Mercury, Coco and the Sweetmeats is an up-and-coming psych pop band that has been called one of Seattle's best-kept secrets. The band is made of Vanderkrimp and his wife Laura on drums. Vanderkrimp grew up in South Africa, where as a teenager he got into the grunge and Britpop scene. He then moved to Seattle and formed Coco and the Sweetmeats. The duo have been releasing albums since 2007, but their latest LP, Sacrifice, has grabbed the most attention and has been the most popular among their growing fan base. The album has a garage band feel with a powerful pop sound. Coco and the Sweetmeats played this past Wednesday at the Elle Street Social Club in Portland.
Mariana and the Baby Vamps, along with Heather Kazur, will perform at the Walters Cultural Arts Center in Hillsboro tonight, Friday, November 18th. Headlining the concert is the female trio Mariana and the Baby Vamps, who recreate a variety of vintage 60s retro pop and soul. The group brings a classic sound to their audiences, both in their arrangements and the impeccable songwriting of Mariana Phelan and Reese Marshburn. As reported by the Hillsboro Argus, French jazz musician Heather Kazur will be the opening act. Tickets are $15 in advance and $17 at the door. This is the final concert in which they will perform as Mariana and the Baby Vamps. They will play under the new name, The Bylines, on Friday, December 16th at Jimmy Mack's in Portland.
The nostalgic pop band M83 has just released their latest album, Hurry Up, We're Dreaming. French musician Anthony Gonzalez sings vocals for the band and adds a screamo aspect to the pop songs. As reported by Ned Lanaman of the Portland Mercury, Hurry Up is an uplifting record and one of the most rewarding albums on the local pop scene this year. Gonzalez says that the album is about human stories, and he also pulled inspiration from his fascination with dreams. He wants each listener to interpret the songs in their own way. The album has already received great reviews, and after 10 years of making music, M83 is finally gaining popularity. They played this past Friday at the Wonder Ballroom.
Portland native rap artist Bill Maculate recently released his Free Skrill Walton EP. Although the tracks may seem like extra material that didn't make the highly anticipated Skrill Talk full length, they still rank among the top local releases of the year. The Portland rapper has certainly made a name for himself through hard work and perseverance. He first came onto the scene as a freestyle battle rapper, both as a Scribble Jam champion and back-to-back winner of Grind Time's World Rap Championship. Following his numerous wins, he continued his buzz by collaborating with renowned group Sand People and countless guest spots on other projects. As reported by Ryan Fain of the Portland Mercury, Bill Maculate also appeared on the Green Tape earlier this year, a project with producer G-Force, also known as Calvin Valentine. This past Saturday, November 12th, Ill Mac made a hometown stop on his West Coast tour when he performed at Branson in Portland. All the attention surrounding Ill Maculate has increased his international fan base and continues to shed light on the Portland music scene.
Future Islands has made a name for being big and bold. Their songs have been full of heartache, and they purge their emotions through their music. The synth-pop band made a big entrance at this year's Pickathon Music Fest in Happy Valley, which began to get them noticed. As reported by Gabe Vodica for the Portland Mercury, Future Islands did not get such hot reviews when they first began to make music. But their newest record, On the Water, strips away their old image. Vocalist Samuel Herring wrote much of the album from inspiration he found through a week-long trip alone around Georgia. On the Water gives a smooth southern feel to their edgy sound. The band played this past Sunday at Mississippi Studios. For more upcoming shows and information on the band, you can head to future-island.com.
Don't worry, music addicts, we'll be right back with your weekly fix of music news.
I got no pulse, so losing him.
Charging. He's in VFib.
Shock him.
Guys that rode all the time. Just had a few drinks. This can't be happening.
Are we clear?
Clear.
You just buzzed.
Just buzzed? You didn't tell us that, sir. You're right. This isn't happening. He'll be fine.
Yeah, I feel good.
Really?
No, not really.
Buzz driving.
Clear.
Maybe we should stop acting like it's no big deal.
Shock him.
When I have an asthma attack, I feel scared. Sometimes my parents have to take me to the hospital. I feel like a fish with no water.
You know how to react to their asthma attacks. Here's how to prevent them. Call 1-866-NO-ATTACKS. Visit www.noattacks.org or call your doctor. Because even one attack is one too many.
Mike and our field correspondent Sarah got a chance to talk with the Little Rascals in Eugene.
Let's catch up with her and see what they had to say.
Hey Oregon State, I'm Sierra with Bombshell Music News. I'm at the McDonald Theater in Eugene, here to check out the Little Rascals. Let's go find out where these rascals are. So I got to catch up with Little Rascals. How are you guys doing tonight?
We're doing fantastic.
We're doing swell.
Okay, your guys' performance was awesome. How
Thank
was it
you.
Out there?
It was a blast. Seriously, like just getting everybody into it and everybody was having a good time. It was super fun.
It was pretty cool just see like our fans come out. And,
okay, so how did you guys get the opportunity to open for a Root Down?
So basically what happened was I contacted one of the DJs, Val Steele, for K-Dub 104.7, and I just said, hey, you know, you might like our music. You should check it out sometime. And I actually didn't hear back for about a month and a half. And then I just randomly got an email, and she was like, hey, you guys want to come open? And then they also offered to do radio play and all this stuff for us. So it's just they've been supporting us a ton, which has been really cool.
So that must be pretty cool to hear you guys' music playing on the radio, people calling you.
It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. Like at first, like it was like, wow, like we were played once on the radio, and then my friends would talk to me and they'd be like, oh, I heard you today. I'm like, wait, it's like 4 o'clock. Like, we got played like last night at 8 o'clock, and then they start playing our stuff all the time, and it's like, it's pretty cool. Like, yeah.
Okay, and then this morning you guys also had an interview with
We had an interview with the Morning House Party. That was super fun. We just went to the studio and got to hang out with them and talk, kind of chat. So that was, seriously, it was a blast. It was kind of weird, like, going to the studios because we've grown up listening to K-Dub for so long. So it's really fun.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. So how do you guys know each other, and how did you guys get started with music?
You can answer this.
Oh, well, actually, we just kind of, I don't know, it was like, just little things were that just brought us together through music. Me and Trey like a different genre, I liked a different genre, and we've just always been playing with each other, but never like together, like in a legit group. And so we just said, all right, hey, let's try this, and it just worked out really well.
And we actually met in like first grade. We've been like next door, like practically next door neighbors, like rock throwing distance. We've been living next to each other that close for ever, since first grade. So that's kind of like what I guess started it all.
So that makes it pretty easy to get along, and you know.
Sure, like we've been friends since first grade, so it's worked out really well. Like getting to do this with, you know, my best guy friend, it's been really cool.
Okay, well, also you guys are both students. How is that managing your time with trying to pursue music, and I'm sure you guys work as well. It could be pretty busy.
It's been really busy, just with work and stuff, and like trying to just like manage all my time and like having time to do. To have fun too has been really hard because, you know, it's always been busy, work. And so having like downtime has been my biggest issue.
As artists, what are the obstacles that you guys have faced?
You can answer this.
I don't know.
You know? I think some obstacles we face are just getting our music out there has been really, it's hard because we're not being supported by like a record label or anything.
Yeah.
And so trying to get our music out there has been really tough.
Okay, so how can people check out your music? What's the best way?
Facebook. Go to Little Rascal, or actually www.facebook.com/ Little Rascals with a Z.
Okay.
Little Rascals with a Z.
Make sure to check them out. Also, do you guys have an album out? Are you guys working on anything right now?
We released an album in August, this past August. It's a 10-song album called Homecoming. You can download that for free on our Facebook page, and we're also working on some new singles right now, so new stuff coming.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah.
Yes, it'll be a lot of fun. I'm excited for you guys here.
Okay, and collaborations, are there any artists out there
there's,
that you guys are trying
few,
to see?
There's been a few artists that we'd like to collaborate with.
Blase.
It's just Blase.
Blase.
We've been trying to find local talent that we really like and get along with well and feel like would fit really well with our genre. So.
Okay, now when writing your guys' music, what inspires you?
Everything, literally. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like just like waking up inspires me. So I mean, like it just literally, music is random. So it's like, and a lot of our music is random, and we love it. So that's what we do. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Well, you know, thank you guys for taking the time to chat
us.
With me. You guys are doing awesome. Everyone out there, make sure to support Little Rascals.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for hanging out with me. That was Little Rascals. Go ahead and support them and follow them on their journey towards stardom.
your pulse hasn't changed yet. Changed from the second you walked into this place. And change is what Barack said. Changes like the seasons will stop when the first sight of sunlight hits me then.
Coming off the weekend, everybody's freaking. Tell me what you're seeking, the mending of the V-thin.
Talk just comes to open, everything unspoken. Coming up on me then, but yeah.
That's what she said.
Come on, talk to your DJ, could you turn that record up?
We'll be popping till we're rocking, till we blow these speakers up. On the floor,
to the core.
Till we're screaming, yeah, you're screaming that we want some more.
Come on, talk to your DJ, could you turn that record up?
We'll be popping till we're rocking, till we blow these speakers up. On the floor,
to the core.
Till we're screaming, yeah, you're screaming that we want some more.
Till the doctor rips me open just to see what's inside. It's a heart, I'm alive. Then we'll see where we've become. A walking image of our songs.
We're living hella strong, strong to our core. We'll always leave you wanting more. It's the time we take in our eyes, in our everyday. We'll take it to our show, sold out tickets so we can go. Come on, talk to your DJ, could you turn that record up?
We'll be popping till we're rocking, till we blow these speakers. On the floor,
to the core.
Till we're screaming, yeah, you're screaming that we want some more.
Come on, talk to your DJ, could you turn that record up?
We'll be popping till we're rocking, till we blow these speakers. On the floor,
to the core.
Till we're screaming, yeah, you're screaming that we want some more.
Come on, talk to your DJ, could you turn that record up?
We'll be popping till we're rocking, till we blow these speakers. On the floor,
to the core.
Till we're screaming, yeah, you're screaming that we want.
Come on, Dr. DJ, could you turn that record up?
We'll be popping till we're rocking, till we blow these speakers. On the floor,
to the core.
Till we're screaming, yeah, you're screaming that we want some more.
That's all the music news we have for you this week, but be sure to catch us next week.
And don't forget to stay tuned for more Music Fusion Fridays.
See you next week! I